Hallelujah. And they begin to see that, and not to top it all off, as they're looking at the glory of God, there was preparation taking place here to communicate the goodness and the need of God. They could take that remembrance of what they saw and what they experienced and take it out to those who have an ear to hear, those who have a desire to know, and say, I've got some good news to tell you today. There is somebody named Jesus, hallelujah, that can save your soul. There's somebody named Jesus that can change your life. There's somebody named Jesus that can give you peace when all the stuff in the world is falling apart. There is somebody named Jesus that when I saw him, gave me desire to be like him.
Amen.
And the anointing filled their eyes, and they saw his glory. And to top it all off, the Bible says all of a sudden the shining cloud, a shining cloud, overshadowed it. Kind of the Shekinah glory of God. Just overshadowed them, and a voice spoke out of heaven and said, this is my beloved son. This is my dear son. Listen to him. And all of that remembrance flooded the hearts of the disciples as they were called to Galilee, back to one of these mountains. It caused a refreshing and a resurgence of revival to fill up their soul and fill up their capacity again to go back out, just like it was on the first day that they found him as the Messiah. The first day they ever saw the first miracle done. The first day they ever heard the first word from God declared. It brought that refreshing upon them of joy and zeal and a want to, praise God, to go out and tell everybody everywhere, oh, come and see a man. He's a sea walker. Come and see a man. He's a lame man healer. Come and see a man that can open up the eyes of the blind and set the captive free.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Preparation was a place of sequence that led them back down memory lane to remember the things that God has done. And that's part of the process of fulfilling the Great Commission in our lives. It's allowing the Spirit of God to bring to remembrance the great things the Lord has done in our lives. That will bring the Spirit of refreshing upon us and revival to give us the strength again as we wait upon the Lord to go back down with a newfound zeal, just like you had the first day you ever found him. I don't know who you are and where you are today in Christ, but if you have found Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, you know that something happened. Confessed to him as Savior. Something happened in your life when you asked him to come and forgive you of your sins. It's a hard thing to explain. It's better to have experience than try to explain. But something happens when you make a connection with Christ. It proves the Word of God to be true. When you are offered eternal life and you accept it by faith, and a disciple is being made, God confirms that. And he bears witness with that soul around the altar that says, Lord, I don't understand it all, and I don't know how to put it all together, but I'm coming to you. And I accept it for myself. I believe that you did die for my sins, and you rose for my life. I believe that you died on the cross and went into a tomb and rose from the dead. I do believe that if I believe in you, I will not perish, but have everlasting life. That weight and load of guilt is lifted. That feeling of depression and oppression and no purpose in life is washed away. Something happens where you get up from that place where you feel light as a feather. You feel a song flood your soul. You feel like you're walking on the clouds. You feel a joy that is hard to explain. I'm talking about an experience with God that you can have because His Word is true. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God says, I'm going to make you disciple makers. And the way the Lord does that, he stirs us up by way of remembrance so that we can have an experience and remember that experience that led us to our call. Hallelujah. When we go out and tell people about the Lord, a lot of the reason we don't or shrink back and make excuses because we just don't know how. What do I say? How do I strike up a conversation? What if they reject me and make fun of me and mock me? What if they just, you know, really verbally abuse me? What do I do? What do I do? I'll tell you what you do. You share with them your experience in Christ. You let them know that what God said he would do, he did for you. I want to tell you today, if you're here and you don't know Jesus, he wants you to become a disciple of his. He wants you to follow him in the ways of life. And the way is simple. It's just by simply making a choice to follow him. I want to tell you today that if you'll make that choice and you'll do that today, something will happen in your life.
Amen.
Something's going to happen that's going to make a change. When you genuinely and sincerely say yes to God, he makes a difference. I want to see a hand of somebody here today that has accepted the Lord, and you know that he's made a difference in your life. There is someone here today, you made a choice for God, and it's made a difference in your life. Hallelujah. To be a disciple, we just need to be prepared.
Amen.
To be a disciple maker, we just need to be prepared. To be one that goes out and wins others to Christ, we just need to be prepared. And our greatest preparation has been our experience. Hallelujah. You've been called to the kingdom for such a time as this. Hallelujah. Amen. God's not called us out there to debate. He's not called us to prove we're doctrinally right. He's called us to love him and to love people. He wants us to have the Jesus factor flowing through our soul. What did Jesus do? He was moved with compassion to tell people that there's a kingdom. There's a kingdom called the kingdom of God. And to help people to find their way to it. Hallelujah. That's the essence of our existence as Christians. To fulfill the great command and to fulfill the great commission. Hallelujah. Let for the worship team to come back at this time. You're not here by mistake today. You're not here by mistake. I want you to bow your heads and start praying. Would you do this for me today? Would you just think about your own life? Don't look around at that person that's next to you. Don't worry about what they're doing, what they're thinking. I want you to think about yourself.
Because he did it for me.
Amen.
God
you're without the Lord in your life, you've never decided to invite Him into your heart and forgive you of your sins, you're just like I was. You have no idea the opportunity you have and the life that God wants to give you until you make that choice for yourself. So if that's you today, we're going to open up these altars in just a moment. And when we do, you want to make that choice today. We want you to come. It's your choice. You can say yes, and God will change your life. Or you can say no, and you can leave this church the same way you came in. But that's your choice. And God loves you. He doesn't want you to leave unchanged. But you'll leave unchanged, but He still loves you. And He's not going to give up on you. But today is the acceptance time. Today is the day of salvation. Here's a great opportunity for you to come and make that choice. On the other hand, you might be a Christian today. You've been serving the Lord for some length of time. And I'm going to ask you this question. As you remember all the things that you have been through in your life, think about all the experiences God has given you. He's given you those experiences for a reason. It's not just for you. The experiences that God has given me and has given you, it's not just for us. He wants us to take those experiences and those things He's allowed us to have in our life so that we can use it in confidence and tell somebody else what He has done for me, He can surely do for you. And if we're not disciple makers, we are not fulfilling the mandate. We are not doing what God has called for us to do. And I'm going to place a call upon you today and ask you this morning, for those of you that are here and you want to be a disciple maker, you want to take to heart the great commandment, the great commission. You want to really do what God has called you to do. Do this. Go out and deliberately and very sensitively move out for God to fight someone and give them the same opportunity that God gave you. Would you stand your feet with me today? Spirit of God, I thank You for the Word. I thank You today, Lord, for the privilege of delivering it. I know, Lord, Your Word will not return unto me void. It will not return unto You. But God, it will accomplish the purpose for which it has been sent. Lord, You are dealing with hearts today. Lord, I know I can do more. To be delivered. To really, Lord God, be sensitive to the souls around me. For there are multitudes in the valley of decision even today. Multitudes ready to receive You as Savior. Help me, Lord, not to go about that haphazardly, but Lord God, realize the intrinsic value and worth of a soul. Because You said, He that wins souls is wise. Lord, today send out Your Holy Spirit to draw hearts for men and women. Men and women, today, Lord God, to be disciple makers. Lord, as You got ready to go into glory, this was the final commandment upon Your church, to go and make disciples. I wonder today if the Spirit of God has been tugging at your heart, if the Lord has been speaking to you in a very personal way, and saying, you know what, I'm talking to you today. I'm telling you, I want you to be a disciple maker. And if you do feel that way, I wonder if you would be bold enough, because it takes boldness to be a disciple maker for God. I wonder if you'd be bold enough to get out of your seat, come down and present yourself to the Lord, not to me, not to this church, but to the Lord, and say, that's me, I want to be a disciple maker for Jesus. I want to commit myself to God today in a way that, you know what, I kind of let go of. I want to really be one that's sensitive to the leading of the Holy Spirit to speak the name of the Lord, to tell people about Jesus. I will commit my ways to the Lord. I will be a disciple maker. Would you get out of your seats and come today? As these are coming to present themselves to the Lord with disciple makers this morning, how about you? What is your state? What are you doing? Are you today, you haven't decided to live for Jesus, you're not a Christian? Then, you know what, there's several people up here that already are. You're not going to stand alone, but if you're here today, and today you know without a doubt, today is the day for you to make a choice. Today is the day for you to accept Jesus. Come down to the front of this church. And let us pray with you here. Hallelujah. Spirit of God. This altar is open for you. Why do we come and have people come to the altar? Because all through the Word of God, it was at the altar that the fire of God fell. It was at the altar that people brought their offerings and surrendered things to God. The front of the church at the altar is a powerful place. Sure, you can pray and you can make a commitment there to be a disciple maker for God. But there's something about the front of the church around the altar of God that changes men. So I make one more call, then we're going to worship to God and pray for these. If you want to today, to commit your ways to the Lord. You wanted to be a disciple maker for Jesus. Would you come and gather together with these in the front and let's make that commitment right now. Come on, get out of your seats and come.